invites and encourages all who are seeking a community to empower, support, and explore deeper understanding of spirituality and recovery of all kinds. We join together with our family and loved ones in our journey to enlightenment and recovery, and supporting one another spiritually without judgment or prejudice.
Sometimes I lay under the moon and thank God I'm breathing. Then I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There will be no wars and our children will play. One day, one day, one day, one day, one day, one day. It's not about win or lose, 'cause we all lose when they feed on the souls of the innocent. Blood-drenched pavement, keep on moving though the waters stay raging. In this maze you can lose your way, your way. It might drive you crazy, but don't let it faze you, no way. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There will be no wars and our children will play. One day, one day, one day, one day, one day, one day, one day this all will change. Treat people the same, stop with the violence and down with the hate. One day we'll all be free and proud to be under the same sun, singing songs of freedom like one day, one day, one day. One day, one day, one day. Oh, one day, one day, one day. One day, one day, one day.
Hi, thank you for joining us here at A Place of Faith. My name is Linda B., and today I'm going to be your spiritual guide as we explore growing and developing spirituality together. First, let's start with prayer. Higher Power, thank you for all that is said and all that is learned. God, thank you for being with us, for surrounding us, for enlightening us, for helping us to grow in all the ways we know we want to grow. God, we would see you with our family, our friends, all of our loved ones, knowing that where there is God, there is good. Knowing that where there is God, there is love. knowing that our prayers reach into and through our higher power and into the world. And so it is. Today, I want to talk about Memorial Day. So we're going to break protocol again. We've done that a couple of times recently. Because, as you probably know, tomorrow is Memorial Day. And Memorial Day is kind of a big deal for a lot of us. So Memorial Day actually started in 1868. And for the longest time, it was called Decoration Day, not Memorial Day. Over time, that's kind of changed, along with our traditions and how we remember people. The whole idea of Memorial Day was to remember our troops who have fallen in battle, remembering those who have given their life in service to this country. And not only those who have given their life, but also the families that supported them, that lost them, that walked through having someone not come home. That's what Memorial Day is. And we certainly don't want to take away from that in any way, shape, or form. Our troops, which I've always felt like we should call them our kids, who served in battle, oftentimes they didn't even want to go. They didn't even know what they were fighting for. Or they believed that, hey, no problem, I'll come back. And they went again and again and again and lost their lives. And because of that, the world changed. I think that's important. And that's really the message that I wanted to share with you as we grow and develop spiritually. I imagine each and every one of us has lost someone that we weren't ready to lose, or know of someone who's fought a battle and lost. There are a lot of battles out there, and a lot of times we didn't even want to fight them. We didn't sign up for that. So often we lose people to disease, cancer, any disease. Sometimes that disease is addiction or alcoholism. Battles we didn't even know we were fighting can take our lives. And those of us who get left behind have a lot to deal with, especially if the death came suddenly and we didn't know it was coming. Especially if we felt like this battle had been won and then it came back and reared its head again. It can be really scary. And a lot of us can have a lot of trouble believing that there is a higher power, that there is any kind of a God who would allow these things to happen, these lives to be lost, these people that we love to be taken from us, just taken out of our lives. It can be really hard to imagine that there's any kind of a benevolent presence or force, anything bigger than we are when we watch things like this happen. A lot of us have had those questions. And I imagine these questions will continue on all through time. I would ask you to honor the memories that you have of these people, and to really be aware and honor the roles that the family have and what they're going through when these losses happen. It's through, so often, these losses that major change comes into the world. Of course, if we're talking about our troops fighting battles for our country, the hope is that we overcome the bad guys and we fight for the American way and we're able to stand on our principles and our morals. We don't fight a lot of those battles on our on our land, on our ground. But we did. We had the Civil War. It was major. And the war to gain the freedom to become a country, also on our land, brother against brother. Can you imagine? Of course, I'm running a parallel here with other battles that we go through, that sometimes we sign up for, and sometimes we never signed up for this. I'd really like to honor some of the big ones that have paid the ultimate price. Martin Luther King, George Floyd, Breonna Taylor. Not all of these people signed up to fight a big fight, but they certainly gave their life. And it certainly is a battle, isn't it? A battle that we need to carry forward to bring about peace and understanding. So often the battle that we fight is internal. It's inside us. It's not about guns. It's not about knives. It's not about who wins. It's about what are the thoughts that go through my mind? What are the beliefs that I hold? How do I treat people? Am I who I want to be when I speak? Do I honor people in a way that is worthy of who I'm trying to become? What about Harvey Milk? What about the people who started AA, Bill W? What about Jimmy? These are people that fought, that argued, that worked their entire life to bring out of the shadows, out of the hidden places and into the light, the battles that so many of us are fighting. I know that I recovered because when I needed a meeting, there were people sitting in that room to welcome me, to believe in me, and to give me that meeting, to give me the guidance that I needed to hear. If it wasn't for the people who had come before us, the people who died in their disease, those meetings might not have been there. I'm not saying it makes it worthwhile for anybody to give up their life. I'm not. I am saying that if people believe in something so strongly, they are willing to die for it. Or if people die in situations and the public is so incredibly moved that they speak out, we need to listen and we need to honor the road that these people have taken before us. It's because we're standing on their shoulders. It's because of who they have been and what they have given that we are who we are. We can't pay it back. But we can pay it forward. We can remember those that we have lost. We can remember those who can no longer speak for themselves, and we can be their voice in the world. We can share their memories with joy, with pride, and with honor. And we can use what they stood for as a measuring stick as to who we are and what we stand for. I invite you to remember, to really spend some time on Memorial Day in memory of the battles that have been fought, of the kids, the adults, the grandparents who have fought this battle, all battles, and why. Why did it mean so much to them that they gave their life, that they stood up before the world and said, this needs to change, this is important? And what do you stand for? What do we stand for? We're still here. We have the opportunity to use our voice to be the change, to really honor the memory of the people who came before us, by holding and growing their vision, by creating the world that they were working so hard for, by not dropping the ball or saying, wow, too bad they're not here. Guess what? We are. We are the people that are here now. We are the ones to stand strong, to be the voice of reason, to be love in all things, to bring forward love, acceptance, and understanding, to live in forgiveness and morals, to have a relationship with God of our understanding, whatever that is, however that is. Know it, and grow it forward. We have the opportunity to continue the work that is not done, to remember the wonderful men and women who have given their lives for what they believe in, to really look at ourselves and see, who are we and who do we want to be? What is the world we want to create for our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren? What is it we are passionate enough to stand for? Happy Memorial Day. Please join me in prayer. Father, Mother, God, higher power, we give thanks for all of the wonderful people, all of the battles that have been fought and won, all of the love and light that pours into the world when we open the doorway for it. Into it. And so it is. Amen.
Hi, my name's Becky R. I want to thank Linda for inviting me to talk to you today about the principle in action of basically for here for Memorial Day, the people that have helped me with a hand up to get where I'm at in my recovery and in my life. One of the great things about recovery is we know that there's, you know, since 1935, we've got a lot of people ahead of us on this track. For me, when I started in recovery, my first sponsor was the one that meant the most to me. She is an amazing person because she still is alive. And she was there for me when I didn't even know what it was like to be there for myself. The first time I ever heard the term standing on someone else's shoulders, which Linda's going to share, is I heard a minister say that she wouldn't be who she was if she didn't stand on somebody else's shoulders. And it took me back a little bit because I wasn't really sure what she meant by that until I took it into my practice. And then I started realizing that, you know, it's really easy for me to look back at my past and say, well, you know, my parents were alcoholics and this and that, and all these things happened to me. However, there were people that were there for me as well. The people that helped me up, the people that took my calls in the middle of the night, the people that listened to me cry and sat in the stillness with me, the women especially that taught me how to pray. I really hadn't had a background with prayer or connection to a higher power. And in fact, it was quite the opposite. I had a lot of trauma around the thoughts of God and that I wasn't good enough for God. And when I had these people stand there with me and say, you know, you are worthy, you are lovable, you are who you are, and thank God you're alive, I started to stand on their shoulders and I started to move forward with my life. Clearly not under my own power. It had to be something greater than myself because I did, to that point, I didn't have the power to move forward in my life. So remembering and honoring all of those people that have been there for us in our lives, not only the veterans that fought for our freedom, the people that have fought for our sobriety, the Bill W., you know, it's so easy to go about my day and just think that I'm here by myself. And I am, in a way, in my present, the humanness that I am, but I wouldn't be who I am if I hadn't had this trail of people that helped me stand and that, like I said, were there for me. So that is my share on the principle in action. Thank you.
I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for the memories. Remember the good times that we had. Let them slip away from us when things got bad. How clearly I first saw you smiling in the sun. I wanna feel your warmth upon me. I wanna be the one. I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. Weep not for the memory. I'm so tired, but I can't sleep. You're standing on the edge of something much too deep. It's funny how we feel so much, but we cannot say a word. We are screaming inside, but we can't be heard. I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. And weep not for the memories. Afraid to love you, but more afraid to lose. Clinging to a past that doesn't let me choose. Once there was a darkness, a deep and endless night. You gave me everything you had. Oh, you gave me life. I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by. And weep not for memory. Weep not for the memory.
Hello, I am Vicky Y. Thank you for joining us on this Memorial Day. I invite you now to find a secluded place where you can be comfortable and undisturbed. Close your eyes and begin to breathe deeply and slowly in and out. Breathe in calmness, serenity, and peace. As you clear your mind of disturbing thoughts, go deeper and deeper into peaceful relaxation. Now listen. In Flanders fields the poppies blow. Between the crosses, row on row that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. This is the first stanza of a poem by Canadian physician, Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae. It was written on May 3rd, 1915, in World War I, after McCrae had presided over the funeral of his friend and fellow soldier, Lieutenant Alexis Helmer, who had died in the Second Battle of Ypres in France. The complete poem was printed on December 8th, 1915, in the London magazine Punch. It was an immediate success, and its reference to the red poppies that grow over the graves of the fallen soldiers in France resulted in the Remembrance poppy, which is still worn by people on Memorial Day to symbolize their appreciation of the sacrifices made by others. Consider the words, in Flanders fields the poppies blow. A beautiful, peaceful image. Picture it in your mind's eye, the green grass, the red poppies, the white markers. Feel the gentle breeze as it sways the red poppies to and fro. Now think of all the people who have made sacrifices for you. Think of the people for who you have made sacrifices. Not all sacrifices are huge. Sometimes they are small sacrifices, but they are all still sacrifices lovingly made. But sometimes sacrifices are the ultimate sacrifice. Remember now the ultimate sacrifice that was made on our behalf by the Creator's Son. Now, as you quietly return to your present reality this Memorial Day and prepare yourself to enjoy watching games on TV, picnicking with your friends and family, or whatever else you plan to choose to do. Remember, in Flanders field, the poppies blow, and the larks still bravely singing fly. Thank you, and have a blessed day.
A lot of us grew up believing at any moment we could lose it all. And at the drop of a hat, God might turn his back and move on. A lot of us feel like we blew it, thinking that we're just too far gone. But I want you to know that there's still a hope for you now. And no matter what you do, done. You can't erase His love. Nothing can change it. You're not separated, no matter what. There's never been a better time to get honest. There's never been a better time to get clean. So come as you are, run to the light and be free. Oh, be free. No matter what you've done, you can't erase His love. Nothing can change it. You're not separated. No matter where you run, He's always holding on. You're still a daughter. You're still a son, no matter what. You're still a daughter, you're still a son, no matter what.
Thank you, Jody. And as we bring this session to a close, thank you to everyone who participated and to you for attending. Thank you, thank you. And now with the closing prayer, the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is dying that we are born to eternal life. Thank you, and have a wonderful week.
Being in recovery means being of service. Locally, the Salvation Army is looking for food donations. The San Diego Blood Bank is looking for donations. And the McAllister Thrift Store is also looking for donations of any kind. You don't know what you want to do or volunteer? Look at volunteermatch.com.
Join us in spreading our message of recovery. Send your donations to Unity Church of El Cajon, 311 Highland Avenue, El Cajon, California, 92020. Be sure to put in the memo, it's for a place of faith. You can donate online as well at unityofelcajon.org. There's a donate button. It's safe and secure.
We want to work with your organization. We have speakers with decades of experience. We do workshops, speaking engagements, spiritual mentoring, lessons, and more. Give us an email at aplaceoffaith@sohomail.com.
Stay connected and updated. We're on Facebook and YouTube. Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
A Place of Faith is sponsored by Unity Church of El Cajon.